Who was Muhammad? Muhammad was the messenger of Allah, the final messenger of Allah, the beloved of Allah. We are here today to commemorate his lifestyle, his life, his example, which all commenced with his birth, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. I'd like to call the deputy president of the South African branch of Muhammad the Sixth Foundation for African Ulema, just to inform you that the South African branch is but one of the 34 branches across Africa. And we'd like to call Shaykh Muhammad Milanzi, the deputy president, to give us an opening word and a welcome. Shaykh Muhammad Milanzi is also the muqaddam of the Tijani Tariqah in South Africa, and he's very active in Pretoria, Johannesburg. Bismillah, Shaykh Muhammad just comes back from Senegal 3 days ago after having spent over a week there in commemoration of the Mawlid with the people of Senegal. Shaykh Muhammad Milanzi, please honor us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما أغلق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق والهادي إلى صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله حق قدره ومقداره العظيم ورضي الله تعالى عن أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته الحمد لله We would like to give thanks and shukur for the program director who has given us an opportunity to say one or two words in welcoming all of the ahbabs. We would like to, first and foremost, after thanking Allah and praising Him and sending salutation upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we would like to also show our gratitude and thankfulness from His Majesty, King Muhammad VI of Morocco, who has established this institution with its noble objectives. We would also like to make mention of the guest from the Chancellor of the Embassy, Dr. Atif, and also on behalf of the executive of the foundation, as well as the members of the foundation, all of the esteemed guests, kullukum bi ismikum, with everyone with their names, and also the members of the various turuq that have honored the invitation in order to take part in this blessed month. We would like to say welcome all of you in this Mubarak and blessed occasion. Just a word about the foundation itself. The foundation, its primary purpose is to promote the three main principles of the Aqeedah of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the Aqeedah of, as documented by the known Imams, the Ash'ari and the Ma'aturidi radiallahu anhum, as well as the promote the fiqh of the imams that are followed by the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, as well as to hold on firm on the tasawuf, which is a very necessary component, as was understood by the hadith of Jibra'il alayhi salam, the tasawuf of Imam al-Junaid, as documented by Imam al-Junaid. Let me specify it that way, otherwise others might get some other ideas. But it is as it was documented by Imam al-Junaid radiallahu anhu, and it is practiced by many different turuqs of the Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. And the reasoning behind this is to promote a correct understanding of Islam that does not create conflicts and enmity among various groups of diverse backgrounds. We all know that the imams, whether in fiqh or in tasawuf or in aqidah, there were some differences. However, those differences were all within the parameters of the Quran and the Sunnah. Without these luminaries, we don't have Quran and Sunnah. Our Sheikh Imam Hassan Sisi radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to say, as an example, if somebody comes to you and say, I will teach you the tariqah tijaniyah, and by that he means anything other than what is found in the Quran and in the Sunnah, then he has misled you. And likewise, any other imams of the tariqahs that promoted the inheritance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they've professed and worked very hard to preserve the deen as we have it today. In the Shadhili tariqah, you have Imam Sid Ahmad al-Zarruq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who worked tirelessly in compiling a lot of epistles in order to guide the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I would not take very long because we already started late. I was scheduled to speak for an hour. However, I've reduced the talk to 5-10 minutes. I would like to end this welcome by a line of poem which Sheikh al-Islam, Sheikh Ibrahim radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in Yas of Kaulach in Medina Bay, he wrote Dawaween, which is a plural of Diwan. Diwan itself means a collection of writings and compilation on a specific topic that is arranged according to alphabets. So he wrote Dawaween, meaning Diwans of Diwans, if I may put it that way. All of them in praise of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is a chapter in his, there way in which he says, فَأَهْلًا بِشَهْرٍ قَدْ أَتَى بِالْمُخَصَّصِ مُحَمَّدٍ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ سِرِّ الْمُمَهَّسِ. That welcome all the month that has come with it, the chosen one, the one that has been earmarked, who comes with special qualities. And that is none other than our master Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abdullah, the slave of Allah. He is the true slave of Allah. He is the secret that embodies the specialities that Allah intended to bring by creating him. He carries on and he says, لقد جال قبل الكون في الغيب وحده بعز وتشريف وسر مخصص. He was moving about before. Now this line refers to that incident in which it is known from the various traditions, about the awaliya, an-nur al-muhammadiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when Allah wished to create creation, He created a light from which the rest of creation was created. The details of the various ahadith, because I know there's difference of opinion among the ulama on this. There's a good book called Nur al-Bidayah wa Khatm al-Nihaya, where the detailed tahreej of all the analysis of various ulama on this ahadith is tabled, but this is not the time to go into that. But Sayyidina Jabir ibn Abdullah said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Bi abi wa ummi akhbirni, may my mother and my father be sacrificed for you. Inform me, akhbirni, inform me, what was the first thing that Allah created before He created anything?" The Prophet ﷺ, he said, "O Jabir, inna Allah khalaqa qabla khalaqa kulla shay'in nura nabiyika min nurihi." Allah created, before He created anything else, the light of your Prophet from His light. And this is a very lengthy hadith. This is a celebration of the beginning of the universe, the beginning of Islam, the revelation of the Quran. Were it not for Sayyidina Mustafa Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah would not have created everything as is documented in various books. So I leave this to the rest who are coming after me to expound on it. We say, Ahlan wa sahlan bi shahrin qad ata bil mukhassasi. You welcome all of you with a month that has come with it, somebody very special. Subhanallah bihamdihi, subhanakallahu hamduka wa la shahadu wa la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.